Hey guys, welcome to another episode of The Vinyl Den, your channel for record collecting by record collectors. I'm Nick. Today, I'm checking out a new way to add LED lights to your turntable. There's a bunch of links down below for you to check out. There's links for the Vinyl Den Facebook group, for the merch page, for the Spotify and Apple Music playlist that I put together every week, and the Patreon page. Make sure you check all that out. Like always, if you enjoyed the episode, make sure to give me a thumbs up. Hit that subscribe button down below. Make sure you hit that notification bell so you're notified every time I release new episodes. So it was probably about 2 years ago that I added LED lights to my turntable. I did a whole video and put it up on the YouTube channel here of how I did it. So basically what I did was I bought a 10-inch ring light from, I think it was Five Below I bought it from, and took the LED light strip out of the inside of it and added it to the bottom side or underneath the platter on my turntable. But like I talked about in that video, the issue I was running into when I did that, and I eventually figured out the correct placement for the LED strip light, was trying to find an area where I could put it under the platter and not have it, the LED lights rub against the bottom of the platter. And any kind of friction like that is going to impact the speed of the turntable. It's going to cause, you know, unnecessary noise also. So it was, I had to kind of find a good spot for it. I end up having the LED lights aren't exactly center under my platter. I had to kind of tilt them off to one side or offset them off to one side a little bit to get the cords to go up underneath the platter and not cause any kind of issues with rubbing. And even though the end results look really cool, I've enjoyed how they look over the last couple of years. I've ran into a lot of other people that have had really similar issues trying to put something under their turntable, under the platter of their turntable to illuminate it, and having issues with trying to find spacing or find something small enough to fit in the space and not cause any kind of issues with, like I said, either the speed of the turntable or the sound overall. So over the last couple of months, I've been seeing this new product pop up time and time again on the especially in the Fluons turntable Facebook group that I'm in, of a new way to do LED lights on your turntable, something that's not underneath the platter. Actually, it affixes to the backside or just behind the platter to illuminate the platter itself. So this new LED light option is, this is a product by Grady Plastics. They've got an Etsy page. I'll put a link down below if you want to go and check out their products. So there's a couple of different options they have with this light. So they've got a white light version. They also have a multi-light version. They also have there's a white housing and a black housing also. So it kind of depends on what you want to do or which one is going to match the plinth on your turntable. I will say, I think this is only available for the Fluons turntables that have an acrylic platter on there. I'm not sure if Grady Plastics has any plans to eventually kind of branch out and be compatible with other turntables, but as of right now, this is only available for Fluons turntables. And what's great about this product from Grady Plastics is there's no adhesives or tapes or anything like that. There's no adhesive that you're taping down onto the plinth of your turntable. You're not going to damage it all. This actually attaches to the backside of it. And, I'm really interested to see what they do in the future, if they're going to branch out and do some stuff for other turntables, because I think this is something a lot of people can use and enjoy. I guess I should also add that these things sell out pretty fast, but they do restock them pretty regularly on their Etsy page. So follow them on Etsy. You can go on, they're on Instagram at Grady Plastics. I'll put links down below for all their social media accounts and their Etsy page. So what are you getting exactly in this little box here? So this does have nice detailed step-by-step instructions. Looks like the only thing you're going to need is just a Phillips screwdriver. And then this is the 3D printed housing. It's got the LED light in there, and then this is the cord, and this is actually, I think this is a really kind of interesting way to attach this to the turntable. I'll show you that in a few minutes. And then this is the multi-light version that does come with a remote. So I took the cover off of the turntable so you can see the installation of this a little bit easier. So essentially what this is this is just a plastic housing, and it's got these rubber feet on the bottom of it. So there's really, like I said, there's no adhesive or anything like that that's going to hold it on there. It's just the weight of the housing itself is going to just let it set on the plinth of the turntable. And then it has this bracket that screws into the back of the turntable to hold it all in place. From this angle, you can kind of see that the LED ring light that's on there now is off to the one side a little bit and then slid towards the back a little bit to allow the wires to slide out of the back without causing any friction on the bottom of the platter itself. So this system here is going to completely eliminate any kind of possibility or any kind of friction or anything like that on the turntable or causing any kind of sound issues. So on the back of your turntable, there's a small screw right here. So you're going to go ahead and take that screw out. And then you're going to take this housing and you're going to use the screw that you just took out to attach this to the back of the turntable. I will say make sure you use the right size screwdriver for doing this because you don't want to strip that screw out of the back of it. All right, so then you'll take the Allen wrench that's included, and you'll take this screw out of the top of this housing here. And then the lid of this is what's going to keep the wires and hold all this in place. So now that's nice and snug, you can see that's not going anywhere. And then those rubber feet are holding it to the turntable. You see just kind of jiggling around. It's actually moving the turntable. It's not going to slide at all on the top of the plinth here. So this is the end product here. So this, you get the, like I said, you get the housing back there on the back. Once I turn this thing on, you can see that it fully illuminates the acrylic platter on there. So this is only going to work with a turntable, a Fluence turntable that has the acrylic platter. So you got this multicolor version that's available, and then you have the solid white version, which that's the solid white there. So that's the new LED turntable light from Grady Plastics. You know, it's super easy to install. It looks great. The only thing I'll add is, you know, the cord for the LED light is a little short. So I had to use an extension cord to get it to reach the outlet. But other than that, you know, it takes, you know, just a couple of minutes to install this thing. It's definitely an easier way to add LED lights to your turntable than the way I did it before with the ring light underneath the platter. You know, it's definitely more of a labor-intensive process, taking the whole thing apart, taking the platter off, you know, and getting it all to fit, where this just kind of, like I said, like I showed you in the video, it just attaches to the back, screws in, you know, just a couple of minutes, and you get to LED lights. And that's really all there is to it. That's the new light, the new LED turntable light from Grady Plastics. Like I said, I'll drop all the links down below if you want to check them out online. Check out their Etsy store. The only thing I'll add is the cord for the LED light is a little short, so I did have to use an extension cord to get it to reach the outlet. But other than that, it's a quick process. You know, as you saw in the video, it just sets on there, you know, just the one screw on the back of the turntable, you know, and you got lights on your turntable. It's really easy process. It only takes a few minutes. I think it's a fantastic product. It's definitely a lot easier than the process I went through to add lights to my turntable, you know, taking the platter off and everything that kind of goes along with that, and taking the belt off and getting the lights to align perfectly under the turntable or underneath the platter without causing any rubbing or friction. You know, it's definitely a lot easier to do something like this. Well, that's all I got for today, guys. Thanks for checking the show out. Make sure you drop me a comment down below. Let me know about if you're interested in adding lights to your turntable, whether you have a Fluence or not. You know, like I said, I'm not sure if there's plans for Grady Plastics to expand later and do other turntables. But right now, this just fits on the Fluence. At least I believe it only fits on the Fluence turntables. But, you know, check them out online. Check out their Etsy store. Check them out on social media. Like I said, they sell out pretty quickly, but they do restock. You know, it seems like every couple weeks they're adding new stock to their site. So make sure you check all them out. If you enjoyed the episode, make sure you give me a thumbs up. Hit that subscribe button down below. That's all I got. Until next time, keep on spinning. Peace.